familial communion. Life and death.
Kiss me hard before you go. Summertime sadness.
My name is Justin Scholder, also known as Phasmahammer. I'm a primarily a storyteller, and that manifests in diverse forms, primarily performance. So I work within a body of work called Phasmahammer. Phasma comes from the Latin phasma, which means spirit, and hammer is from the Wunderkammer, so it kind of means like a cabinet of spirits. So it's my own cosmology. I have always been into world making, and I think that probably comes from gaming. So like early PlayStation and some even like earlier like Atari, as well as those kind of like image-based technologies and sound composition. I think it's informed me, especially to do with the hybridity of bodies and self-representation and portraiture, and as well as like how I can tell the kind of stories I do in diverse means. Yeah, often there's this kind of perception that the mask or the costume is something that conceals the form, that conceals the psyche and the wearer, but actually for me I think it's something that very much reveals my inner psyche and the multiple facets of my concerns and interests. I like to create super overwhelming, affective openings for people to engage with performance. I hope to open the portal for everyone when I perform at ACCA.
I'm Tianzhuo Chen. I'm an artist. I'm also a theater director, but I normally just call myself artist. My work is mainly to do with installation, video, and performance. My work deals with much more about bodies, emotion, and rhythms rather than technology. I make my artist statements through others' body. Even when I work with a lot of the videos, but I never feel the video is something like the live performance. A lot of my characters in my video or performance, they're from religious story, ritual, ceremony, creating a mixture in my work. I'm interested in like transforming the boundary between human to animal or to divine being or devil or living and dead. That's how the characters transform in my performance.
I'm Zadie Xa. I am a London-based artist, originally from Canada, and I have a practice that employs a few different disciplines. I would say that my practice overall is performative, and I use painting, sculpture, installation, video, sound, and live performance. I am essentially someone who strongly believes in making, and because my background is in painting and object making, I very much employ technology as a way to just kind of create shapes, let's say, or sculptures with sound or moving image. So when I use video, I'm thinking largely through collage, assemblage, and painting. I think one of the things I found really frustrating about conventional painting was I wanted to tell a lot of stories that were fractured, and I wasn't able to do that within just a pictorial surface. I'm interested in the idea of garments being shape-shifting items in which one would be able to change character, you know, both physically and conceptually or narratively. I think that idea of self-mythologizing or writing oneself into their own narrative where you see your face so distinctly looking back at you is really powerful. For many people that have hybrid identities or find themselves in between cultures or geographical homelands, I'm really interested in that space in between and what the possibilities are for that.
Hi, I'm Sahej. I'm an artist from Bombay. The work that I do can be seen as this growing mythology that's kind of like expanding and sort of seeping into our world. The kind of objects that I make and are sort of like artifacts of this fictional civilization. I use a lot of objects that I'm finding that are essentially like kind of being sort of discarded by society. So like, you know, the viewer kind of brings their own memories, dreams, you know, things that these objects might remind them of, and sort of imposes them on the object, and then we collectively make meaning of these objects. In the show, I'm presenting this one, this AI program. You'll sort of encounter these you know, quadrupeds and these bipeds that are sort of roaming this landscape. Yeah, and then it kind of produces music based on these interactions within itself and with the way people sort of respond to it as well. What is the potential of new tech? Like, what are the stories that it can tell? Like, you know, what's the poetry that it's capable of creating? That's the kind of stuff I'm interested in, like.
I'm Madison Bycroft. I am an artist from Adelaide, who is now living in Marseille in France. The text as an object is something that's sort of emerged in the last couple of years, in especially in my video and performances. But I'm also always responding to the craft that I work with, to the environment, and so there is always a level of improvisation.
They could be seen where seen is written with a strike through. Vision is stricken and struck.
The clock struck.
Oh, struck.
Oh, are struck.
Struck me that.
The storm struck.
Yes.
Bruises and Refusals is a film across four channels.
How, 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 how.
saying too much or sort of explaining the work, because I'm not interested in doing that. I was interested in each of those characters' relationship to refusal of expression or form or engagement.
Not much will be said.
Not much,
says Peter, who is in this scene playing the role of Buster Keaton.
The way that we read anything, I think, is unfortunately for most people a very visual practice, and I think the legibility or refusal of legibility is something that's it's a central interest. Costuming or disguise is something that can kind of play with that legibility or distract or refuse to give away certain information.
This is the scene where Julian of Norwich dreams of the blobfish, will not smile, refuses expression.